Hey, what's up, Acers? It's Bryce. In today's video, we'll be playing some Minecraft. So if you don't know what Minecraft is basically a game that you can play on your computer, your iPhone, your Android, basically your PS4 now, your PS3. It just came to PS4 2 days ago, and I just got it. But Minecraft is just like a building game. As you can see, there's a ton of stuff to do. There's a ton of blocks. I have a bunch of traps around, but let me show you some of my traps. This one, you step on a pressure plate, it goes off, TNT goes off behind. Beneath it, and then you go into a lava pit. That's my first invention. And let's see. Oh yeah, by the way, this is like a wall to keep people out of my fortress. And then these are turrets. So as you can tell, as soon as I step on this wire, well, that turret's not full, but like the turrets that are actually like full of arrows, like those, they're gonna go off every time I try to mess with them. And then back here are some more traps. I just have some basic traps back here. And it goes back there, but I guess I can show you it, but this is basically like an experimentation room. By the way, the reason why I'm showing you this is because Minecraft is very diverse and very creative, and it really gets creative and diverse thoughts going through your mind, which is really healthy for you, actually. But look at this. You switch that on, TNT blows up, and I have a wall full of nothing that can explode, so nothing actually does explode. It literally just does that, and then if you wanted to put the TNT back, then you just go into your blocks, you put TNT, and you place it right there. And then you gotta rebuild your redstone path. This is called redstone. You gotta rebuild that path, and then you gotta turn this switch off, because otherwise your TNT's gonna blow up. Yeah, the switch control, by the way, yeah, switch can go on and off. And then you put the TNT back for the next time you use it, so. Let's go to the next part of my place. I had animals over there before, by the way, so this turret was actually aimed at those animals over there, so I was actually, I actually did kill my own animals, because they're not even there anymore, which tells me I'm a terrible person. But, here's my, I have just, like, all this random stuff. I have, like, a room in there, as you can see, like, I have a bed right there. And then if you go up this huge ladder, I have a spinning cart, just like, it kind of reminds me of my brain, it never stops spinning. And this is kind of just like I said, you can put your own thoughts into Minecraft, you see, like, this is my brain, it just never stops going, there's always thoughts going through it, really good thoughts, and some bad, I mean, really good thoughts, but, just keeps going and going and going, and then I can release it, and my mind just keeps going. See what I mean? You can symbolize Minecraft with, like, so many different entities. But let's go on to the next part of my castle, per se. I just started building this like 2 days ago, by the way. So yeah, this is just like only 2 days of work. So as you can imagine, you can spend like an eternity on Minecraft before you're actually done with it. So, I mean, Minecraft just goes on and on and on and on. All right, let's go down here. Nope. I guess we'll go down here first, since that's where it's supposedly leading me, but we can go wherever. Yeah, I make underground water slides. I don't know why. I just find the joy in making an underground water slide. I don't know why. I used to have Pocket Edition, but my phone broke, my iPhone 4S. So I had to rebuild my water slide. It doesn't take that long, actually, because when you're on creative mode, you can like switch between blocks and stuff. But when you go on survival, like, you don't have any blocks, so you have to mine everything. Basically, you have to get all the stuff yourself. You have to figure out how to build everything. But on creative mode, you can just build everything. It's kind of nice, though, because on creative mode, you can build all your stuff, and then you can use it for survival mode. So, like, fill your chests up with whatever. I have my chest filled up with arrows for the turrets in case they go bad, because I'm trying to use the turrets to fight, like, monsters and all the demons, and even, like, maybe enemy players that enter my world when I don't want them to. But here is the first stop we are going to make. This is just like a large tunnel, as you can see, lava, water down there. It's like a waterfall, technically, I guess. And then see my little secret passageway. I love making passageways, by the way. Choose a stone block. Go up, up. Wood planks. And then we're gonna just go all the way up. Wait a minute, you can fly on creative mode, by the way. It just makes everything a lot faster. But that is covered like that, and then I'm gonna replace that with a grass block, and then let's go to the next passageway. I always lose my spot, that's the problem, because like my grass blocks are always like like the exit is always so far away from the original place. As you can see, yes, I just built this today. I built these walls and that trap outside, which is kind of nice. Minecraft is so diverse. There's even like a way to make a zipline. You actually have to have a mod for it. But if you don't know what mods are, by the way, basically they're just like hacks that you make to your game. And I don't know how to do that on PS4 exactly, but there's a mod for everything, especially in Minecraft. I even heard of a guy who built a functioning iPhone in Minecraft. I don't know how, but he apparently made, like, put all these blocks together and made an iPhone that actually functioned on Minecraft. So, I mean, this game is just crazy awesome, I guess. Like, it's only been around for, like 5 years, but it looks like it's been around a lot longer because it has that older style, but that's the whole point of Minecraft, that everything is, like, block-like, and you can make anything out of blocks, which Minecraft really gets your creative juices flowing. So this is like my gem room, as you can see. I have all my nice gems in this room. And then here's another secret passageway once again, which leads to my favorite spot actually on this map so far that I've created. Let's see if we go down here. This is actually a trap, so if you hit this button, you think you're gonna get through that door, right? But in turn, you're actually not. You're gonna go straight down into lava pit. And then you gotta use your cart to get around. Your minecart, I mean. Let's see. Place that there. Go. That there's something to the left right there. And you can exit that way, but you won't ever know it because the minecart goes so fast all the time, so you would never be able to tell that's where you can actually exit. And I have a really cool like little maze underground here that I built. This doesn't take long to build. This only took me a couple days, by the way, so I mean, it's pretty easy when you're on creative mode. You just don't have to work that hard for it, which is nice. And I usually just get rid of that. And then we can go up here. And then I have a cave, as you can see, another cave. And I torched it up because if you don't put lights out in like a cave then, or in your like anywhere in Minecraft, then like if it's dark at all, monsters can like evade. So that's why you got to be really careful. But that is my world of Minecraft so far, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to like, comment, leave a comment. What is your favorite video game? Is it Minecraft? And if so, why? Or what do you think can make your thoughts more creative and your thoughts more diverse? I think it's Minecraft is one of the things. Minecraft just has that way about it that you never stop inventing. Like, there's so many YouTube channels dedicated to Minecraft and just dedicated to, like, there's always things that people are finding about Minecraft that, like, hidden things. Secrets, Easter eggs, basically, which are secrets, but there's always things about Minecraft that people are constantly finding out, so don't forget to like, comment, and don't forget to subscribe, and leave in the comment section below what makes you guys more creative. In my opinion, it's Minecraft, and how does that creativity, like, make you more diverse as a person, because I think so many times our minds need that creativity to find that diversity within ourselves. Leave a comment below, don't forget to like, and don't forget to subscribe. Everyone stay saucy, and don't forget to have a saucy Saturday.